So you might have taken a few data science courses already, and you feel that it's finally time to apply for your first data science position. You hit search, but when you scroll through the job requirements, you begin to wonder if anyone's even going to bother looking at your application. Hey everyone, welcome to the channel. If you're new here, my name's Leon, and last year I graduated with a master's degree, and after that I spent a lot of time trying to find my first data science job. I spent roughly about 8 months, and you know, due to the pandemic situation that we find ourselves in, we all know finding a job nowadays is much more difficult than usual. This was especially true due to lockdown, and I spent ages stuck at home trying to figure out ways to improve my chances of landing that first data science job. Since I've had a few people ask me for advice on how I landed my first data science job, in this video, I'm going to share with you what I learned during my job seeker days, which I'm going to cover in these key points over here to help you increase your chances of landing that first data science job. So let's get started. So when I was looking for jobs, I always pretended that I was an employer instead. So if I was somebody running a business and I was looking to hire a data scientist, why should I invest in you instead of the other applicants? Especially considering that data scientists aren't cheap. Now, data science is a very broad field and nobody's expecting you to be an expert at everything since this is your first data science job. But there needs to be something that makes you stand out from the crowd and shows that you're genuinely interested in working as a data scientist. And this is where the mindset of showing your work comes in. It doesn't matter if you think nobody's going to look at your work, it just needs to be available, it needs to be online, it needs to be easily accessed, because doing so will increase your chances of success, because it acts as proof that you can actually do the things that you say you can do. If your work is good enough, you might even get some social proof. For example, on GitHub, people can star your project. You know, if you get a lot of stars, that's something that you can use to your advantage. You can talk about that. You can say that your project was successful, a lot of people liked it. If that doesn't convince you enough to put your work online and show your work to people, then think about it this way. If you didn't do anything, you didn't post anything whatsoever, and people can't access your work, then it's guaranteed that nobody will see your work. In this day and age, I think most people tend to submit digital applications. They don't just print out a piece of paper and send it to people. Unless you're at like a conference or something. Most of the time you're applying digitally, and so you can easily just include hyperlinks to your projects. And that's what I did. I made it very easily accessible for people who wanted to look at my work. And I even had a personal website as well on there, so that if you wanted to check out all my work in one place, you can easily do so. I even remember getting a bunch of machine learning engineer interviews despite not having a machine learning engineer background, thanks to this project that I did that I posted on GitHub. It had a fair amount of stars, and it was presented clearly and concisely. It was easily accessible from my CV. And so that kind of thing really does help you get your foot in the door for your first interviews, especially if you have social proof to back it up. In case you're interested, I'll include the link to the project in the cards above. I also wrote blog posts as a way of improving my writing and storytelling ability, and I did have some interviewers question me about those as well. So it doesn't really matter what format you publish your work in, it just needs to be something of value and something that you can access easily online, because one day you will have that employer that will go through everything, and by that point you'll be so glad that you have it all laid out nicely and presented in a clear and concise way. So you might have guessed it by now, the best way of showing your work is by doing projects and getting involved with the data science community. You can do this by writing blog posts that perhaps solves an issue that a lot of people are having, something that maybe you understand that other people don't, or you can do projects and post it online. Now, I think a lot of people feel quite intimidated with projects, and especially beginners, you know, they feel like they have to learn everything first before they actually start doing anything. From my experience, it's much better to learn just enough to get started, because the bulk of your learning will come from actually doing the projects, and it's much better to finish a flawed project than to do endless research and never apply any of it at all. For example, in the computer vision project that I linked earlier, I learned just enough about computer vision to get started, so I learned the basics of object detection and object tracking, but then the bulk of my learning actually came from the issues that I came across along the way. Try to show that you can create value even if your project ended in failure, and that you know why you failed. Once you finish the project, you can tidy it up and finalize it and share it with the data science community, and you can do this by sharing it on websites like GitHub, Medium, Kaggle, or even your own personal website. Just don't let this opportunity go to waste, because even if you think your work isn't amazing, there might be somebody out there that's interested in looking at your work. So for networking, you hear this one all the time. It's not about what you know, it's about who you know. And it's no different for data science. Making the right connections with the right people can really have a positive impact on your data science career. Because of the pandemic, for people like me who are a little bit more introverted, it was fairly easy to make connections. And so I made a lot of connections through my work, and especially on places like LinkedIn, where I would ask people if they had any roles available or if there was anyone that they could refer me to. Now, in my case, I didn't actually land any job interviews by doing this, but I did know some people who did manage to get their first interviews by making the right connections. So again, it all boils down to increasing your own chance of success, and you can only really do that by showing your work and putting yourself out there. Now, this one's a huge topic with a lot of variables, so I'm not going to go too much into detail about this, but basically you have to feel comfortable with talking about what you've done. In every interview that I've had to go through at least one project that I've done, and I've had to emphasize on what I've learned and any valuable insights that I've gained from actually doing it. Of course, the basic interview skills still apply here, but since data science is a very project-based field, this is really something that you need to try and perfect. If you try and follow the previous steps of organizing and presenting your work online as clearly and concisely as possible, then I'd say that's a great starting point. You could even suggest to the interviewer to go through your project by clicking on the link on your CV. I've done that a few times before, and it's much easier to get them interested and get them engaged in what you're actually doing. Also, from my experience, some companies have asked for a take-home project to be done. Hopefully in that situation, you'll already have done a few projects and you kind of know how to approach the problem already. I've also had some companies ask for a coding test, although that's not as common as a take-home project, but I think it's probably enough just to know the basics of SQL, R, Python. To me, data science interviews tend to be more about how you solve a problem and the impact that your results can provide. So now that you've done some projects, you've gotten involved with the data science community, you've updated your CV, do you just spam Easy Apply on LinkedIn? Well, you could do that, but I'd say don't get too carried away with it. As you're applying for data science jobs, go back to thinking like an employer again. Think about what employers would like to see, because there's always something that you can improve on. I'm also pretty sure that you'll be failing plenty of interviews. Not trying to be negative here, but due to the increased competition from the pandemic, it's only realistic to assume so. Take what you've learned from these interviews and adjust accordingly, because you'll constantly improve and you'll constantly learn about what works and what doesn't over time. Just don't fall into the trap of doing a few projects and thinking that that's enough, because if you want to maximize your chance of landing that first data science job, you have to continue to iterate on what we've discussed so far. So that's basically it from me. Just remember that this is an iterative process. The more interviews that you do and the more projects that you do, the more you'll know what works and what doesn't work, and you can adjust accordingly. I know from first-hand experience how intimidating it is to apply for that first data science job, so hopefully this guide has made it a little bit easier for you. If you're interested in learning about what it was like for me when I first got my data science job, I've got a link to the blog post that I've put in the description down below. I've also got a video that I'll link up here, and if you like the video, please like and subscribe, turn on the notification bell, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.